George Pullman began his career lifting buildings. He took over a business started by his father and moved warehouses and barns to allow for the widening of the Erie Canal. In the 1850s, officials in Chicago decided to raise their whole city 10 feet to allow for drainage of its mud-clogged streets. George Pullman jumped at the opportunity, directing hundreds of men. He lifted houses and hotels, even an entire city block, without breaking a single pane of glass. Pullman developed his first railroad sleeping car, the Pullman Sleeper or Palace Car, in 1864. President Lincoln's body was transported on one of his sleeper cars, which gained him national attention. In 1879, he purchased 4,000 acres of land south of Chicago, 600 of which would be used to build the first American model industrial town, Pullman, Illinois. Pullman constructed a model town adjacent to his huge factory on Chicago's outskirts. The town featured the Midwest's first indoor shopping mall, elegant library, parks, playing fields, and neat brick homes for the workers. He hired African-American porters in need of work, but he paid them starvation wages. They had to rely on tips and endure the scorn of racist passengers. He created a beautiful town, but he charged exorbitant rents, posted demeaning rules, and allowed for no town government. The company ran the show, and Pullman's spies invaded employees' privacy. Rather than sell his cars, he retained the ownership but contracted to various railroads to add them to trains to entice passengers. Pullman then pocketed the extra fare. He kept complete control over the operation and maintenance of the cars. Pullman's architect, Solon Spencer Beeman, if I'm saying that right, was said to be extremely proud that he met all the workers' needs within the neighborhoods he designed. The distinctive row houses were comfortable by standards of the day and contained such amenities as indoor plumbing, gas, and sewers. During the depression that followed the panic of 1893, the demand for Pullman's cars lessened. The company laid off hundreds of workers and switched many more to pay-per-piece work. Despite these cutbacks, the company did not reduce rent for workers who lived in the town of Pullman. In 1894, the workers initiated the Pullman strike, which lasted for 2 months, eventually leading to intervention by the U.S. government and military. With rail service interrupted and the U.S. mail disrupted, the situation escalated to a national level. U.S. cavalry troops and soldiers with bayonets were soon confronting rioters. Several dozen citizens were shot dead. A court soon ordered the company to sell off the model town. When Pullman died 3 years after the strike, he left instructions that his body be encased in reinforced concrete out of fear it would be desecrated. After the strike, Pullman was gradually absorbed as a regular Chicago neighborhood. By 1972, the Pullman Historic District had obtained national, state, and city landmark status to protect the original 900 row houses and public buildings built by George Pullman.